Hello, and welcome to today's tale. Once there was a boy called Jack, and Jack lived on a farm. Now, I've always thought it would be wonderful to live on a farm. But Jack, well, he wouldn't agree. For you see, Jack's farm was always noisy. Even before the sun had come up, the cockerel in the farmyard would begin to crow, and Jack would think, "Oh no, why can't I just have a bit more sleep?" The cockerel, he didn't care. He raised his voice to the fresh morning air with a cock-a-doodle-doo. Get up, Jack. Get up, Jack. Cock-a-doodle-doo. And when the cockerel crowed, well, that meant it was time for the hens to get up. And the hens would go out into the yard and start to buck, 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 buck. And as the cockerel and the hens bustled around calling for their breakfast so they would wake up, the cows in the barn, and they would begin to moo. Where's our fresh hay? Jack, wake up today, moo. When the cows began, well, that would wake up the horses. Neigh, neigh. And when the horses were awake, well, the sheep followed suit. And soon there was a cacophony of noise in the farmyard. Cock-a-doodle-doo! Muck, 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 muck! Moo! Nay! Bah! Jack did not stand a chance of getting back to sleep. So he would clamber out of bed, put on his clothes, and go downstairs. His mum would already be up. Come on, Jack. The animals are waiting. Off you go. And Jack would barely have time to have his own breakfast before he would have to go out and feed the animals. But there was one animal that Jack loved. An animal on the farm who wasn't like the rest of the noisy bunch. No, this animal was as quiet can be. And Jack always loved to go to Nelly. Nelly the goat. Now it might surprise you to hear that a goat was so quiet. But in all her life, Nelly had never said a word. She had just quietly stood and patiently waited until Jack had come and taken her out of her pen. And then when all of the other animals were fed, Jack would take Nelly out of the farmyard and up onto the green hills beyond, where she would munch quietly and merrily on the grass. And Jack loved that moment in the day when he and Nelly would go up to the hills, for finally Jack would get some peace and quiet. But there was one thing that Jack had to remember. Taking Nelly up to that hill, he would go past his grandmother's house. And Jack's grandmother's house, oh, she had the most wonderful cottage garden, surrounded by a white picket fence. And Jack had to remember that as he went past, to make sure that grandmother's gate was locked. For you see, in that cottage garden, Jack's grandmother could grow anything. And she did. Why? She grew all the fruit and vegetables you can think of. And it was always sunny in Jack's grandmother's garden. And so you would find trees laden with the rosiest apples and pears by the dozen. And there would be other trees full of sweet red cherries. She grew vegetables too. She grew carrots and cabbages. She grew a garden that a goat would find heavenly. And that's why Jack had to remember that the gate was always shut. Well, as you can imagine, Jack very rarely got much sleep, and he was always up early, always busy. And so he was also very tired. And one day, when the cacophony in the farmyard had woken him up especially early, he finally, after feeding all the other animals, arrived at Nelly. "Oh, Nelly! Oh, I'm so tired. Come on, girl, let's go up to the hill. And while you have a munch, maybe I can have a rest. Come on, Nelly, follow me. Here we are, Nelly. Let's tie on your rope. Oh, it's a cold morning this morning, Nelly. Oh, but I don't care. It'll just be nice to get some peace and quiet, finally. Nelly? Nelly? Nelly?" Well, Jack had been so tired he'd forgotten to tie the rope properly. And now, Nelly was nowhere to be seen. Nelly was free. And Jack, with a sinking feeling, looked back towards the farm, towards where his grandmother's gate was open. Jack ran as fast as he could back towards his grandmother's house, but it was too late. Nelly was in the garden, chomping away at his grandmother's carrots. "Nelly! Nelly! You mustn't eat grandmother's carrots! Nelly, you've got to get out of the garden! Please, Nelly, stop! Nelly! Out! Out! Out of the garden you must go!" But Nelly stood firm, carrot in mouth, and she turned and she looked at Jack. And for the first time in Nelly's life, she made a sound. And she refused to budge. Jack tried as best he could. He tried to gently push Nelly towards the garden gate. He tried to tie the rope back round her neck and pull her the other way, but Nelly was having none of it. She just stood her ground and well, finally, Jack didn't know what else to do, and so he walked back towards the garden gate and sat down and began to... Oh, Nelly! Please come out of the garden! Well, Jack's crying soon drew attention. There, by the gate, was a hole. And suddenly, a pair of ears appeared, and a little pink nose, and Rabbit came out and sat by Jack.
Oh, oh, you look very sad. Why are you so sad? Tell Rabbit. Perhaps Rabbit can help.
Oh, well, my goat Nelly, she's gone into my grandma's garden and she's eating all the carrots and I can't make her come out and my grandma's going to be so angry and I don't know what to do.
Oh, don't worry. Rabbits are very good at talking to goats. I'll just go and have a little word. Don't cry, Jack.
And with that, the rabbit hopped into the garden. She went up to Nelly and tapped her on the leg.
Excuse me, Nelly, but you're making Jack very sad. Now, what you're doing is very bad. Now, I like carrots too, but this simply won't do. Please, Nelly. Out of the garden, out of the garden, out of the garden you must go.
But Nelly, who had moved on from the carrots and was munching on the cabbages, just looked at the rabbit, stood her ground and said, "Nah." Well, Rabbit didn't know what to do. She tried to be polite, and so she hopped back to Jack's side. "I'm so sorry, Jack. I tried. I did my best, but she just won't listen to me." Well, soon, both Rabbit and Jack's crying travelled to the farm beyond. There, Jack's dog Scruff came running. "Jack, Jack, ooh, ooh, what's going on? Jack, Jack, ooh, 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 ooh. Why are you crying? Why are you crying? Tell Scruff." Jack couldn't get the words out, but Rabbit instead said, "Oh, oh, dog, dog, it's a terrible thing. The goat, Nelly the goat has got into Grandma's garden and is eating all the vegetables and we can't get her out."
"Oh, oh, don't worry, I, Scruff, will get Nelly out. You just watch me go, watch me go, oh, oh, watch me go, 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 go."
And with that, Scruff ran into the garden and started to go round and round Nelly's legs.
"Oh, oh, come on, Nelly, 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 stop that now, stop that now. You've got to get out of the garden, out of the garden, out of the garden, out of the garden. Go, 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 oh, oh, oh."
But no matter how much Scruff nipped and barked at Nelly, Nelly, who was now munching her way through a wonderful courgette, stood her ground and just said, "Nah." Well, Scruff, who was used to herding sheep, couldn't understand why Nelly wouldn't move. And so eventually he too went back to Rabbit and Jack and,
"Oh, oh, 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 I'm sorry, Jack. I failed you. Oh, 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 oh. I tried, Jack, but Nellie, she just wouldn't move.
And now, the crying from Jack and from Rabbit and from Scruff the dog, well, it travelled much further. It travelled beyond the green hill to the wood. And there in the wood, Fox was just prowling around trying to find something to eat when he heard the cries.
Oh, my goodness me! What on earth is going on over the hill? It sounds like a catastrophe.
And with that, Fox ran as fast as he could over the green hill. And there he saw the blubbering mess that Jack and Rabbit and Scruff the dog.
Oh, my goodness me! What can have happened for the three of you to be in such a mess?
Well, Jack and the Rabbit, they could hardly speak, but Scruff,
Fox, it's a terrible thing. Nelly the goat has got into Grandma's garden and she's eating everything. And the three of us, we can't make her move.
Oh, is that all? Well, leave it to Fox. Fox, if anybody can make a goat move, it will be me. Watch and see.
And with that, Fox went into the garden, strode right up to Nelly, who was now trying to reach the apples and pull them down from the tree.
Now, goat, listen here to me. It's Fox, and you know that you shouldn't be in the garden. Now, leave that apple alone at once, and out you go. Out, out, out of the garden. Off you go.
Nelly just looked at Fox and said,
"No."
And no matter how Fox tried to persuade Nelly, she just would not go. And so eventually he too joined the others by the gate and...
I don't know. I tried my best persuasive tricks, but that goat is fixed on staying in the garden. I am so sorry. I just don't know what to do.
Well, now the noise was so huge that it woke another inhabitant in the wood up. It woke Bear. And when Bear is woken, he's never in a good mood. And he came stomping through that wood up over the hill, and there he stood in front of Jack, Rabbit, Dog and Fox, and...
What on earth is going on? I'm trying to get my beauty bear sleep, and you lot are weeping so loudly that I shouldn't think anybody can sleep.
Oh, it's terrible, Bear. You see, Jack's goat, Nelly, is in his grandmother's garden, and he's eating everything. She's eating everything up, and we've all tried, but none of us can get the goat to move.
Is that all? Said Bear. Well, wait there, for I, Bear, I will make the goat move. There's no need for all of this despair. Just wait there.
And with that, Bear went into the garden. And he brought himself up to his huge full bear height. And just as Nelly was pulling down a pear. He took his big bare paws and gently touched her on the head.
Now look here, little goat. This simply won't do. There's a whole bunch of creatures out there weeping and wailing because you are eating all of grandmother's fruit and vegetables. Nope, it's time you, little goat, got out of the garden. Out of the garden, out, out, out you must go.
But I think you and I know what Nelly did next. She looked up at Bear and she dug in her heels and she just went. Well, no one had ever said no to Bear before, and Bear didn't know what to do. Well, he was big, he was brown, and here was a goat saying no. Well, stunned, he walked back out to the gate and he slumped down too.
She said no.
And he put his big bare paws up to his face and he began to cry too. Well, just then, from the garden came a buzz, buzz, buzz. And suddenly landing on Bear's nose as he wept was a buzz bee.
Oh, bee, bee, what do you want with me? I haven't got any honey. Bee, will you get off my nose?
Excuse me, Bear, and excuse me, everyone. I've been watching what's going on. And if you don't mind, would you allow me to try and get the goat to move out of the garden for you?
Well, Bear stopped crying, and so did Fox and Scruff the dog and Rabbit, and even Jack paused, and they all looked at the little bee buzzing in front of them. Said Bear.
You bee, you get rid of Nelly. Look how tiny you are, Bee. I, Bear, couldn't move that goat in there, nor could Fox or Dog or Rabbit or even Jack. What hope do you think you've got?
Well, please at least just let me try.
And Jack said, well, we haven't got any other hope, so if you don't mind. And Bee buzzed back into the garden. She buzzed up to Nelly's ear. And as Nelly was munching away on the pear, she bzzz, bzzz, bzzz. And Nelly, she tried to shake her head to shake the noise away. But Bee quickly bzzz, went round to Nelly's other ear. And Nelly shook that ear to try and get rid of Bee. But Bee was quick. And Bee buzzed from ear to ear, backwards and forwards, until Nelly was shaking her head so violently that she dropped the pear and ran straight out of the garden towards the green hill. Well, Jack couldn't believe it, and nor could the other creatures, and Jack said, oh, thank you, Bee. I'm sorry, I can't stop, I've got to go and catch Nelly. And with that, Jack ran away to the hill to make sure that Nelly didn't go too far. bee just buzzed merrily in the garden, while bear and fox and rabbit and dog sat there. Finally, after a little while, Rabbit returned to his hole. Scruff ran back to the farm. Fox wandered back over the hill to the wood. And Bear followed too. And as each of those animals went on their way, they thought to themselves, how could something so small achieve something that we larger creatures couldn't do at all? And as for Nelly and Jack, well, from that day on, Jack always made sure that Grandma's gate was closed shut.